One of the great features in Lightroom is that you can create presets for adjustment brushes. Or in other words, you can create recipes for a particular brush. So you can create a brush for skin softening. You can create one for detail extraction or maybe even making the clouds more dramatic during the sunset. But here's the thing with recipes though. Not one intensity of the preset will work with all of the images. Different images require different intensity. And today I'm going to share with you one key, just one key and one secret. One button that you need to hold in order to control the intensity so easily that you would not believe it. It's amazing. Let me show that to you. So here we are in Lightroom, and this is a photo that I took in Clearwater Beach in Tampa area. And let's say we want to enhance the clouds and create that sunset mood. So press K or select the adjustment brush from here. Now, if the sliders are moved here and there already, you can double click on Effect to bring them back to zero or their neutral position. Now what you need to do, let's maybe just decrease the exposure to see where it is painting, just to see. Now let's paint in here in the sky. And now it's time for us to kind of create a preset for this brush. Of course, we are not going to keep it this way. Let's double click on the exposure to move it back to zero. Now let's dial in some settings. Let's increase the temperature to add some yellow to it. Let's go for about 20, that's fine. And let's add some magenta by increasing the tint. 27, 28 is great. Let's keep the exposure as neutral because it might differ from image to image and we can change that later. Let's increase the contrast to add some punch to it. Now, I'm doing a little too much because I'm going to show you that trick and show you the before and after. This is fine. Let's decrease the highlights. Let's go for somewhere about minus 75 to 79, 80 is great. Shadows, we don't want to increase the shadows, that doesn't look right. Don't increase the whites because that's going to make the overall thing a little darker, especially for this effect. Blacks, do you want to do it? Let's do a little bit. Let's go for minus about 15, that's fine. Now, clarity is going to bring in all the details. I'm doing a little extra, keep that in mind. So let's go for a clarity of maybe 42 or 44, that's fine. Dehaze a little bit as well. Let's go for 12. Great. Now, let's have a look at the before and after. This is the before and this is the after. Now, as you might see, this is of course too much. Maybe you want to increase the shadows a little bit. Let's go for somewhere about 34 is fine. Now, when you increase the clarity, it might make the shadows a little darker. Therefore, we need to increase it. Now, let me share with you the ultimate secret, the way you can make it work for all of the images. First of all, let's save it as a preset. Now, you need to click on the custom right there. And click on Save Current Settings as a New Preset. And you can name this Clouds Sunset, right? And let's click on Create. Now this is saved as a preset. Even if you just delete this brush, select this anchor point, press Delete key, it's deleted. So now let's say we are at a strange setting in here or everything is neutralized. All you have to do is to select that preset and start painting. So let's go ahead and choose Cloud Sunset. And just paint on it. That's it. Now here is the secret. These settings might not exactly work for all of the images. Is there a way I can reduce the intensity of the entire brush, the complete intensity of all of these sliders? Well, there's one way. Actually, there are two. The second one is the coolest, and that is the trick. So all you need to do is to click on that arrow right there. Just click on that arrow. Now once you do that, an amount slider will show up. Now, as you increase or decrease the amount slider, see, the entire intensity of the brush increases and decreases. Isn't that amazing? But I promised you one key, didn't I? Let me show you that trick as well. That is absolutely amazing. So all you need to do is this. First of all, let me just reset that to what it was. It was 80, right? So let's set that to 80. Now, even if you click on this arrow and everything is showing up, here's what you do. Here is the point, right? Hold the Alt key or the Option key on a Mac, and then when you click and drag to the right, have a look, the intensity increases. And you click and drag to the left, the intensity decreases. Now, have a look at the sliders on the right-hand side. They are increasing and decreasing in the same proportion. Isn't that absolutely amazing? So I'm going to go for maybe a little bit like this. This is exactly doing the amounts thing, but in a more visual way in which you can drag in right and left, and every slider is moving in proportion to each other. Isn't that amazing? So even if you have a brush for, let's say, skin softening or another kind of detail extraction, you can use it there as well. So that was pretty much it for this video. I hope this video helped you, and if it did, make sure to give us a like, and also don't forget to subscribe, and not just subscribe, ring the bell so that you, my friend, don't miss any other future tip, trick, or tutorial. I would like to take this moment to thank all these nice and amazing people for supporting this channel on Patreon and helping keep PiXimperfect free for everybody forever. Thank you so much for all your support. Thank you for watching. I'll see you guys in my next one. Till then, stay tuned and make sure that you keep creating.